How am I going to be more positive? Oh! Hey guys, what's up? A new video from Lena. In today's video, we are going to talk about positivity and how to be more positive after a trauma, like an injury or something else. So without further ado, let's just get into this video. I just use myself as an example. So basically, when I first got hurt, I was just like so shocked, like, oh my god, what is happening? Like, this cannot be true. Like, I'm young, I'm fresh, I'm happy, I'm healthy. Like, what? Whoa, mind blowing. So, yeah, one day, just out of the blue, I was sick, and yeah, then I have to start all over again. And then, after the first shock, you kind of get depressed just a little bit because life is suddenly not as it was before, and yeah, you really don't know what to do. Well, that's what I felt anyways, because after the first shock you usually go into a depression or like a down period of time, and it's really hard to get out of that again. I have been there for a long time, like for real. Especially if you can't see any, you know, improvement, or yeah, just like life can be really ugly, like after depression or after trauma. So luckily in Denmark we have a psychiatrist, and you can go and get some time with those people, so they can talk you through the grief and, you know, help you, like, you know, life, to love life again, basically. But it's also a lot up to you. So for me anyways, I had a really good therapist for a long time, so that helped me, of course, but also it's also about me. Like, I have to do every single day a lot of work to make sure that my positivity keeps coming to me, because it doesn't come to you after trauma. Like, it doesn't. Today I just want to share with you guys what I do every day to make sure that I, you know, live a, you know, kind of better, more positive lifestyle. So without further ado, let's get into this video. So first things first, it's just very important to look positively at life. And as I said, it can be very difficult after an injury or some other kind of trauma. So to get this positivity in down, like back in your life again, there are some things you can do to kind of like say, come here, positivity, let's go together, dance and woo. Okay, that was just weird. But yeah, so the first thing I do in the morning is to look into my light screen. So it kind of looks weird, but basically it's just a screen, so it's instead of the sun, because in Denmark it's very rainy and not very sunny, so instead of going out and seeing the sun, I can use this screen to look into. You can only do it for a little small amount of time, so I just use 5 minutes just to look into the screen, and that should help with the depression, or if you're a little bit down, especially during the winter time. After that, I take my diary and then I start writing down all the good things that's going to happen on this day. Okay, so let's say it was yesterday, and I would write, today is going to be a great day because I'm going to have my birthday party, I'm going to see my friends, I'm going to get good presents, and I'm going to have amazing cake. So that's all amazing things that's going to happen yesterday. And then after that, I also want to write down what kind of feeling I want to have that day. So again, yesterday, I really wanted to be present and in the moment and with my friends. So listening and, you know, hear what are they talking and what are they saying to me. It's very good to write that down as well with the feeling, because if you are saying to yourself what you're kind of, what you're doing that day, then your brain is more likely to actually do it, because we have to give it a lot of information. And yeah, so as an example, just if you take your phone in the morning and scroll through Instagram, then that is what going to your brain. So if you do the opposite and actually write down all the positive things you're going to do that day, you're sending signals to your brain and telling it that's what we're gonna do today. So very important. You control your mind, not the opposite. Remember that, guys. Remember that. After breakfast, it's also very important for me personally to do some meditation. So if you haven't tried it before, oh my god, you guys, you have to start doing that. That has helped me so much. Like, oh my god, it's just like brain breaks, right? We're talking about that. I've seen Jim Quick. I put a link below to his channel, but he's just always talking about the brain and how to do brain breaks. So one of those is of course meditation, and it's even more important when you're having like me, a brain that's not working so well or like recovering. So yeah, it's even more important to take a little break from everything, and that's very good with meditation. I actually am thinking about putting meditation into my afternoon as well, and the evening, but one step at a time. And that's also for you guys, you have to start somewhere. So you could just start with 10 minutes in the morning, and then after a while you can, you know, do other days, other times a day as well. One step at a time, and in the long run you're just woo. After the meditation, I also need to go outside, because fresh air is just so important. Oh my god. Like, no matter what you're doing and what your trauma you have, like, oh, it's just so important to go outside, like, just for everyone really, but also if you're going out after trauma. That's in the morning, and then in the evening I also do a little bit. So in the evening I get into bed, and then I get my diary out again, and I do just like in the morning. So I write, the day has been good. I write this every single day, because every day is good, because. And then I write three or four things down again and yesterday. So the day has been good because I had my birthday party, I saw my friends, I got some good presents, and I got some very good cake. So it's just been an amazing day. Underneath this, I also wanna write down all the things I have actually achieved that day. So yesterday, for an example, yesterday I wrote the script for this video, and also I did another video as well. So I have that written down. I could also write things down like I got out of bed, I was ready when my friends came. You know, everything really counts, so it's just up to you what you wanna write. If you have more time to write in your diary, then of course it's also very good to write down like, were you productive, grateful, were you good? Where can you be better? Did you learn something today? What did you learn? And those kind of things. I do this not every day because of my tiredness, my fatigue, but you know, I do it like a few times a week at least, just to get even more insight into what is going on in my mind. It's very interesting. I have written down all these steps to a more positive life in a little guide for you guys. You can get that for free down below. Yeah, it's so cool. Yeah! I hope these tips will help you. It really helped me for a positive life, so I'm really happy about that, and I will definitely continue to do it. So that's just amazing, and I hope you're having a great day or evening wherever you are in the world. And remember, you are never ever alone. We are all in this together. So with that, I want to say goodbye from Denmark. Also.